Hey guys, Al Spence here tonight. It's about 11 o'clock. Not a whole lot going on. I'm working on a friend's, real good friend of mine, 67 GTO, doing a replica of his real car for him. Nobody really hardly knows what I used to do for a living, but I worked for the telecommunications company. I worked for him back, put one of the first digital multiplex switching system, DMS 100-200 system in. And that's when your phones got yanked out of your house with rotary dial and went to push button. I put the first switch in the U.S. in Mechanicsburg, Virginia. And did that for years all over the country, a couple countries. So I worked with this cat all over the place, and he got a 67 finally, so I'm building one replica for him. But here is the 68 Dodge Dart Hemi. It's a replica of Bill Flynn's. This car's still around. It does exhibition shows, super stock reunion shows, etc. It's got the wood grain wheel like he had. Seat belts, lap belts, wrist belt. His son actually takes this car to shows. There's a couple of them, but interesting quick story. He, in the 69 season, Chrysler was, you know, saving money as always, as most companies did. And they took, and he ground and covered in these little side markers on it. He changed the grill out to the 69 that didn't have these turn signal lights up here in the front and such. And a few other minute things. It kept the tail lights. Even though the 69 changed a little bit, they stayed. And then he ran this same exact car for the 69 season right into the 70 season. So I guess that's getting the best bang for the buck, unless you're in Tijuana. Anyways, let's peek down here at the hood scoop. Hood off. MSD ignition where his is set. Fuel filter's in it. I got a spring in there. Kind of hard to see me with a little better angle. There you go. Pretty nice build. Came out good. I should have filled the hole in back here where the wiper motor went. I thought his had it. It don't. I left the wipers off. He didn't even have wipers. You know, the factory back then, when they sent these guys cars, these race teams, they were bare-boned. They were just a chassis and a lot of motor and tranny. You know, I had sanded off all the GTX logos on the car, even the hood. And, because they didn't run a GTX. So, a little shot for it. A lot of them big boy carbs. But I got a couple little things to do on this, but it pretty much for practical purposes, it's a wrap. Put the gauges in. That's the ones I make out of. I press them in and use Bondic and redo them all. So, but that's it. That is the Yankee Peddler. Classic car. Not a big Mopar Chrysler guy, but man, dudes, I do respect the Hemis, Chargers, Challengers, and these bad little units, so I think it came out pretty decent. Everybody always said, let me see the oil. You know, oh yeah, Lakewood traction bars. He added them. 69 season, he went with the Lakewoods. I think he got a hint from Grumpy. But that's her. Classic Krager look. I love them Kragers. Tires on this thing. It's a great build, guys. If you want a super stock car and a big body like this, this is a great kit to get for parts, even if you're running a Chevy. I popped a Chevelle body on this. It fits. Even the interior tub lines up on the chassis. So you can swap this out with a big 396 or 427. Use the chassis underneath, save your body for another project, because the slicks on this, they're not tubbed, but look at there. They're a little bit bigger. So gives you a nice fit. Now, I got them to fit up underneath the tires and are tucked in, so I didn't have to sand the fender wells out. I really hate cutting fender wells unless I have to. You know, I tub them just to get around that. So, hey, anybody have any trouble with anything? You need tips, ideas? You want me to do a video on anything particular? I've been asked a couple of times about doing a throttle return spring and fuel lines off the carburetors and stuff. What do I use? How do I do it? Etc. I might do a video on that coming up. I'm hunting for a truck, trying to sell my little S10, and you know, I hate to trade it in. They break you down, load you up like a prom date drunk, and on a your prom date drunk, so it's not a good thing. This guy offered me $800 at a dealership. Yep. Good thing I didn't still drink. Anyways, that's her right there, guys. Aftermarket decals. I think it came out pretty good. Let me know what you think, okay? Like I said, I'm doing a 67 GTO right now. I got the Mission Impossible 55 here. Here's a gander real quick. In here with my few other cars. There's the Mission Impossible coming along. Give you a little sweet treat look. Bench seat, 4-speed. Trunk opens and all. Here's the 60. Here's a 6.7 Go I'm doing. Got that laid down. I'll do a better video on these guys later, okay? I hate to half-crap these, so. Only if you're in a hurry in an airport should you half-crap anything. Alright. There you go, a little gander. Okay, that's it. Enough of that. Any more than that, you're going to have to start putting dollars in the G-string. A little poison dart for you. You guys have a great weekend, okay? Al Spence here for Gulf Coast Custom Models. If you need any help, hit me up, fellas. Y'all have a great week, and I'll talk at you later. Bye-bye.